In this video, I'm going to show you how to join a Windows 11 workstation to a Windows Server 2022 domain. Now, in the previous video, we installed Active Directory domain services on our server to enable us to create a client-server model, a centrally managed network. But we also need to make some changes to our workstation to be part of that. And to do that, we need to join the workstation to the domain. Now, before we get started, if you find the video helpful, please help the video by giving it a like, share it, and subscribe to the IT Taster channel for more content. So if you're ready, let's get started. So this is a lab setup I'm going to be using for this video. I have a Windows Server 2022 domain controller that I set up earlier in the series. It has the DNS role installed. It's a Microsoft Active Directory integrated DNS server. The domain is training.ittaster.com, and over here I have a Windows 11 workstation running Windows 11 Enterprise that I'm going to join to the domain. Here's a quick overview of the configuration settings. We can see the server, which is running Windows Server 2022, the host name, which is Server 1, its IP address is 192.168.1.101. Now for the DNS IP address, you'll notice it's 127.0.0.1. This is known as the loopback address, which effectively points back to itself. And this is because the server has the DNS server role installed. It's a Microsoft Active Directory integrated DNS server, which is extremely important to Active Directory domain services. You can see the domain, which is training.ittaster.com. If we come down to the workstation, we can see the workstation is running Windows 11 Enterprise Edition. I'm going to configure it with the host name of Station 1 and give it an IP address of 192.168.1.120. But for its DNS server, I'm going to point it back to our server, our Microsoft Active Directory Integrated DNS server, which is 192.168.1.101. So let's now go over to the lab and get started. I'm going to start by logging on to my Windows 11 client workstation that I'm going to join to my domain. Now before I do that, I'm just going to perform a few prerequisite type checks just to make the domain join run nice and smoothly. So I'm going to go to settings and we'll just go down and click about. Here it shows us the Windows edition that we're running on the client workstation. Now it is important to check this because not all Windows editions support Active Directory domain join. Windows 11 Home, for example, doesn't allow us to join a domain. Now, as you can see, I'm running Windows 11 Enterprise Evaluation Edition and that does. So we're all good to go. So next thing I'm going to do is configure my network adapter. Go to the adapter properties and I'm going to configure a static IP address because I don't have DHCP running on my Windows server yet. I'm going to keep the default class C subnet mask. I'm also going to configure a default gateway. I don't need this for the domain join, but I'm still going to configure that. And I'm going to specify my preferred DNS server. Now the DNS server that I'm specifying is my Microsoft Active Directory DNS server, which is running on my Windows Server 2022 domain controller. If you remember, if you followed the last video where we installed Active Directory domain services, the DNS role was configured during that process. So I'm going to click OK, tidy this up a little bit, and close that down. And I'm going to go to a command prompt. I'm just going to check connectivity by performing a ping, make sure we can ping the server. So ping 192.168.1.101. And as you can see, that's successful. If you do have any problems with pings, obviously check your connectivity and things like the firewall on the server as well. Next thing I'm going to do is perform an NS lookup. This is because it's important to make sure that we can resolve the server's name and domain name in DNS. So I'm going to perform an NS lookup of server one and the domain training.ittaster.com. And as you can see, this resolves to the IP address 192.168.1.101, which is all good. Now, another thing we can do is ping server one training.ittaster.com. The advantage of doing this is we're performing the two steps in one, because obviously we need to resolve the server host name, server1.training.ittaster.com, first in order to ping it. So you can combine the two steps basically. So with that done, we are now ready to join the client workstation to the domain. So I need to click system, scroll down to about, click domain or workgroup. Now at the moment, our computer has the computer name desktop-108GT09, which isn't that helpful. So I click change, and I'm going to change the computer name. I'm going to call it station one. It's a good idea to do this obviously before we join the domain. And then below, I need to specify the domain, which is training.ittaster.com. Click OK. I'm going to specify the domain admin account, which is /administrator. And the password, and click OK. Click on the hidden dialog box. Welcome to the training.ittaster.com domain. Click OK. And we're reminded that we must restart the computer to apply these changes. So I click OK to that, close that down, and restart. Now I'm going to leave the workstation to restart. While it does that, let's now go over to the server. So I'm just going to log on to the server. Now there is a slight issue under services, so I'm just going to quickly sort that out. It's the clipboard user service and it's set to automatic delayed start. So I'm just going to quickly start that manually. There we go, everything's all nice and tidy and all nice and green. I'm now going to go to Tools, and I'm going to open Active Directory Users and Computers, and expand the domain training.ittaster.com. And if I click on the Computers container, there we can see a new computer object, Station 1, has been created. Now, the computer's container is the default location for computer objects when computers are joined to a domain using this method. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is create a new organizational unit, because organizational units enable us to organize and manage objects and also apply policies to them. So to do that, I'm going to right-click the domain, choose New, and select organizational unit. Give the organizational unit a name. I'm going to call it Training Computers. And click OK. I'm going to go back to the computers container, and I'm going to right click our computer station one, click Move, and select the Training Computers organizational unit. So there we go, we've moved our computer object station one into the Training Computers organizational unit. So all is good here. So let's go back to the Windows 11 workstation and test if we're able to log on and verify our domain join. I'm just about to log into the Windows 11 workstation computer that we've joined to the domain. But this time I'm going to log on using the training domain administrator account so we can test if the server authenticates us. So to do this, I'm going to select other user, and I'm going to enter the domain name training/administrator. Now, the reason I'm entering the training domain followed by a backslash is because the Windows 11 workstation also has an administrator account. So I need to tell the workstation to use the domain administrator account instead. Now, you won't normally need to specify the domain when logging on as a regular user. So I'm just going to enter the password and log on. Now, a new profile is being created, which takes a little while, so I'm going to skip forward a little to save time, and we'll catch up with the video when this is complete. I'm now logged on using the domain administrator account. I'm going to go to settings, just maximize that, and go to about, click domain or workgroup. And here we can see our computer station 1 is now a member of the domain training.ittaster.com. So there we go, we've successfully joined a Windows 11 workstation to a Windows Server 2022 domain. And as you've seen, it's a fairly straightforward process to do that. Well, that brings us to the end of the video. Hope you found it helpful. If you did, please give the video a like, share it, and by all means, leave a comment below. So, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.